this message understands that life is formed of good decisions. See, God believes in you. And any situation that you are in right now, He can turn it around for you, on your favor, okay? And this song talks about that. This song is Psalm 23. And it's a song that I wrote in a difficult time in our lives where we had just gotten married. And the job that I used to have, I lost it. It was just tough. And but I remember knowing in my heart that God said, I'm going to be there for you. Everything's going to be fine. So we hope you enjoy this song, okay?
Thank you.
We have technical problems, man. But it's just normal. That happens all the time. You need to say something?
Do I need to say something?
No.
Y'all want to give him a round of applause? Are y'all going to play one more? Okay, and while they play one more, we'd ask for the presenters to go ahead and make a line and start grabbing their food, and then when they're done, then the rest of the audience can go and grab something to eat. And we would like Paul to come up and say something really quick. Please. And then y'all are gonna play while everybody enjoys and we start making our way out.
We want to thank Ashley for taking time out of her busy schedule to join us today. And Henry, thank you so much for those words of encouragement to all of us. And we appreciate your commitment to higher education and your partnership here with LIT. And where's Donnie? We want to thank you very much for remembering that this is Lamar Institute of Technology, and we appreciate you praying for my South Campus President, Judy Simmons, of Lamar University. We want to thank all of you for joining us today. And remember, if you like to dance today, phone calls will start in an hour. It's 555-111, vote 1 for our dance team. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I want to thank my dad while they're fixing this. He took off work this week to help us, and anybody that has a job knows it's not easy, knows that you can't just take off work. So he really planned this whole week to help us set up and watch the kids so we could practice, and it's just really, we couldn't have done it without him. So thank you, Dad. It's right here.
In Mexico. Let me tell you something. Coming to another country is not an easy thing. Especially because when I came to the United States, there was a church that hired me to come run their sound. And it wasn't an easy thing to do because you have all your roots in your country, your friends, your parents, and you just out of the blue leave everything and come to another country, and you gotta start from zero, you know? So it's really not an easy thing to do. But when we were having the national anthem, and I'm telling you this from my heart, it moved me so much because, see, Mexico is a country that was conquered by Spain. This is my personal appreciation of it, okay? My personal understanding of it. When Spain came to Mexico, it's almost like the spirit of Mexico was broken. Do you understand what I'm saying? Mexico has some social issues that are hard to deal with, difficult to understand. And it's very split. You have the very poor class. You have the middle class that keeps getting smaller and smaller and smaller. And the middle class doesn't like the low class, you know? And the low class doesn't like the middle class. But when I came to America, I saw a country with pride, a good sense of pride, a sense of dignity, a sense of inner value. People that are born in America have a strong sense of dignity. And when I came to America, I wanted to stay here because I wanted my kids to be raised upon that blessing. And I'm not saying this lightly. And I want to challenge you today to, if you are an immigrant, embrace these values. Don't have the mindset of, these American people, they don't eat tortillas, you know? Well, go buy your tortillas. I like tortillas. I'm Mexican. I'm going to die being a Mexican, but there's so much we can learn from this country, and I'm saying it from my heart. Our pastor is here. You know that I'm not lying. I love this country, and I want you to embrace this culture and make it even better, because Hispanics have a rich culture. All the things you saw today is so rich. But I really think that we have to help people from the Hispanic community understand, if you will, that Hispanics have to come out of the shadow. We need to learn that we can do everything. We need to learn a sense of dignity and self-worth. Does that make any sense?
Yes.
If you believe in that, give a hand clap. I want to introduce the musicians to you too. On the drums, we have Ezra, my new friend Ezra. Give him a hand, please. He's done a fabulous job. My friend Moncho, which I love with all my heart. Moncho, thank you for being here, man. He's a fantastic guitar player. Jason on the bass, thank you so much, man, for coming. We appreciate you, man. Literal. Be careful with the click. Just Thank you. Yes, ma'am.
How many more y'all got?
Two more.
All right.
We just stop.
Keep going.
I appreciate so much the conference of this gentleman. Remind me your name, please. Guy from Cuba.
Henry.
You know, those kind of stories, we take them lightly sometimes, but they're so remarkable because people really have to go through stuff when you move into another country because you don't have those roots. But I admire people that push through and push through and push through. And eventually, let me tell you something, if you're an athlete, if you're in school, if you're a musician, if you keep pushing through in life, you will see the benefits. You will reap the benefits of the hard work. So many people along the way give up and settle for less than what they really should go for. Now I want to talk to you, if you are an American citizen, if you're born in this country, you have so many benefits. You know, I was talking to my wife about some stuff the other day. I just want to share this with you. People are dying in war for us to have the freedoms we have here. And I'm not saying this lightly. I just have a passion to encourage people to be the best they can do. Sometimes we have so much in our hands, and we just throw it away. If you are an American citizen, do the best you can with your life. There's a part in the book of Hebrews that talks about the access we have to God. And I wrote this song because for a while in my life I felt like humans or people in the church, I hate to say it, kept putting a wall in front of me. And the Bible says that you can come to God. You can just come to Him freely through Jesus Christ. And if you've never heard this before, I want to sing this song to you, okay? Who starts singing this song?
This time we'll get it right. Yeah.
Almost kind of okay.
Es amor sin corazón. say that song.
Y'all go ahead and skip all the other students.